friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear.
Angels. The legion was like 6,000, so it would have been like 72,000 angels. But instead of doing that, he went ahead and died. We'll go ahead and sing all four verses. If we decide to leave the chorus off of one, I'll let you know.
Song.
Thank you.
good song. Other songs that you maybe like to sing tonight. I made a list. I'm checking it twice. This world is not my home. Was anybody this morning surprised at the proclamation by our president? Oh, you weren't aware. He declared this on Friday, but it's for today. Today is, so that I quote exactly what it is, I'm not going to read the whole thing like I did this morning. But he declared that today is
Transgender Visibility Day.
Yes.
I looked it up.
Yeah, thank you very much. Transgender Day of Visibility. And then I was telling Diane Corder, close that off, it said that not only did he do that, but they were having the Easter egg decorating contest this weekend, and he declared that there were to be no religious symbols and no military symbols for the Easter egg hunt. And then somebody had commented this. I won't take time to read all this, but a lot of people are upset with the president for declaring Easter to be Trans Day of Visibility, but to be fair, the date was selected only because the LGBTQI whatever calendar was already rather full. The Trans Day of Visibility is March the 31st, so every year it's that. Do not confuse this with the Trans Day of Remembrance, which is November 20th. We must also take care to honor Transgender Parent Day, which is November the 6th, Trans Awareness Week, which is November the 13th through the 19th, and International Pronoun Day, which is October 20th. Trans, by the way, is different and distinct from drag. International Drag Day is July the 16th. But not everyone even has a gender to trans. A Gender Pride Day is May the 19th. Intersex Awareness Day is October 26th. And then it goes on, and there's just about a day for every day of or week or month of the year that's designated for something. But he made it very clear today that it wasn't about Easter. It's Trans Day of Visibility. The person that wrote this article and made note of all these things said that his personal favorite, this person that did it, my personal favorite is Gay Uncle Day, which, by the way, is August the 14th. And I only mention that. April says, what does that have to do with the song? The song we're going to sing is This World Is Not My Home. And the longer that we live here in this world, the more it seems alien to all of us. Because nobody would have even thought of this stuff 20, 30 years ago. So we'll sing, This World Is Not My Home.
Thank you.
seeing today that you just never thought you'd ever see in your lifetime?
Haiti.
What's that?
Haiti.
Haiti?
What's happening in Haiti? No government, no law, no police officers. It's just lawlessness.
And I've even heard, as you probably have too, there are even cannibals.
Total chaos.
Roaming the streets. What other things that
run by gangs.
What other things are you seeing today that you thought that you would never see? Anybody been following what's going on with squatters?
Yeah.
People that are actually moving into houses that are vacant, and the authorities are protecting these people that move in there. They're trespassing. They're obviously trespassing. And the authorities are, how many would say they never thought that they would see that you could go into stores and take up to $1,000 worth of stuff and walk away? And so I'm just kind of, it all goes back to the song, "This world is not my home." And quite honestly, I don't know if you're like me or not, but I expect that things are going to get worse. Jesus even says in Matthew chapter 24 that if it weren't for the elect, you know, the things would be, and him cutting short the days, nobody would end up surviving. Things are just going to get that bad. So I just didn't know if there were any things in particular that stood out to you that you would never think that. How about the illegal invasion of our country? People literally coming in by the tens of thousands. So, how about another song?
About 312.
312? Only trusting.
Thank you.
He'll save you. Well, this morning we only sang one verse of 169, which is almost sacrilegious to only sing one verse of it. 169, because he lives. God sent his son. They call him Jesus, came to love, heal, and forgive, but we never got around to singing the other two verses. And so we need to complete this song. How about the starting with the second verse? How sweet to me. Concerning. The song assures us, though, life is still worth the living because Jesus lives. I feel bad for the kids growing up today because of everything that they're being bombarded by. It is a different sort of world. Even things, you know, we talked about, things we never thought we would see. I'm sure that I'm not as old as Joe, but when I was in school, marijuana was considered a bad thing. Was it still considered bad when you were in school there, April? Mm-hmm. And now what? In Ohio, they have recreational marijuana. You can just get it and smoke it for fun. Stuff that we thought we would never see.
I just have a place downtown Winton, that Foundry, that's what that is a dispensary.
Okay. And it's openly celebrated.
It's all about money.
Who would have been?
They can tax it now.
Who would have thought that we would have seen a movement within our country, seriously, to defund the police? You want to talk about one of the most idiotic things that I've ever seen in my life? Well, stop and think about it. If you defund the police, who's going to provide law and order? Who's going to provide law and order? There will be no law and order. It's complete lawlessness. And you had government officials that were advocating for this. But life is worth the living because Jesus lives. How about any more songs?
177.
177. would you have been like, Joe, if Jesus hadn't come into your life?
Well, I can remember what I was like when he wasn't in my life.
I know you described yourself as a foul-mouthed mill worker.
Mill worker.
But it begs the question, what would any of us have been without Jesus in our life? Yes, I know that one. Anybody else don't know? My dad knows it.
I know that my Redeemer lives. I know that my Redeemer is in heaven. The angels sing. everything some Sunday morning.
Yes, ma'am. We'll have to do that. I'm glad to add it to the record. It's a great song. I've wrote down several here. I know that one of her favorites is 762, but that's in the blue book. In the white book, those ones that I wrote down are from the blue book. So, in the blue book, 762, looking forward to the day that we see the Lord. We lay all of these troubles behind.
Thank you.
7/71. We'll understand it better by and by. About sung yourself out? Oftentimes we will close with Amazing Grace. If you have any more you'd like to sing, we'll sing them. If not, we can close.
How about number 319 in the white book?
319 in the white book. Rest. Usually I'm acquainted with it with four verses, but there's five verses in this one.
Number four is not the usual to be sang.
You could still sing them. Oftentimes with a lot of these songs, there will be more than, like the Battle Hymn of the Republic, I don't know how many different verses there are to that. But the Haven of Rest.
Thank you.
ready to... Do you have one, Joe?
Just drop right down, 320.
320, sweep over my soul. Saying Amazing Grace is kind of a conclusion to our song service. Reminder that we are saved by God's grace and kept by His grace. Tuesday of this week is when we'll have the men's prayer breakfast. We will have a regular Bible study this Wednesday. Thursday, we'll be back to the after-school program.
And we need to talk about that, too.
Okay. Okay. So, but I appreciate everybody being here tonight, and pray the Lord will bless you. Let's have a closing prayer. Father, it's been good to be reminded of all that you've done for us. The songs maybe haven't captured everything, but Father, we want to let you know we love you. We sing the songs not to entertain ourselves, but to sing praises to you. You are worthy to be praised. We pray, Father, that you've been blessed by the singing, and pray that you might help the, not just the melodies, but especially the words, to stay within our hearts, because the words are where the real strength of a song is. We oftentimes will hum the tunes, but it's the words that convey, they express our faith. And so, Father, we pray that you might use those words within our lives to encourage us to not only walk with you and serve you, but to be an encouragement to those around us. May they, too, come to know you. We thank you, Father, for sending your Son. Lord Jesus, we thank you for coming and be obedient to the Father. We're thankful, Lord Jesus, that you died and that you died for our sins. We thank you that more than anything, you rose from the grave to give us the assurance that you are the resurrection and the life. We just pray that you might help us to always serve you, to love you, to honor you, and by all means to share you with others. We ask that you will dismiss us with your blessing. Please minister to the needs of all those we've got listed in our bulletin, especially, Father, minister to the family of this man that was tragically killed in the fire over in Richmond this morning. And again, all of the others that we've got on our prayer list, please meet their needs. Dismiss us with your blessing. Bring us back to the next appointed time. And until then, use us for your glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.